2015 saw the first three Bell test experiments that were supposedly loophole-free. Why were there none before 2015? Because it's a very difficult thing to do. These complicated experiments have many physical components. So would it not make a lot of sense to fully investigate how the result varies as the experimental setup varies? Isn't this an obvious thing that we should want to do? Surely the fewer the physical components and the simpler the experimental setup, the more we can trust the interpretation of the result. And yet, the so-called loophole-free experiments use hardware random number generators. The pragmatic thing to do would be to change different physical aspects of an experiment to see how each change affects a Bell inequality value in an attempt to drill down and identify what is causing the violation. Instead, we just have a game of who can produce the most impressive violation. Is this really the game we want to play? By not drilling down to find the cause, have we abandoned the whole essence of what science is all about? There is a huge incentive to produce results that appear to support quantum mechanics. You can publish your results without fear of ridicule. You might become famous and enjoy not just recognition, but admiration from your peers. There's absolutely no incentive at all to report on how changing various aspects of the experiment might affect the result. The danger of doing this is that it might point to a possible local realism explanation, and you really don't want to do that. It would mean that you had wasted months of time and effort. You will have proved nothing except that there was a possible non-weird explanation all the time from the very beginning, that through your incompetence you managed to miss completely. If you were to publish all of this in a paper, then all it would do is tell the world how useless you are. And so many more papers will be published that supposedly confirm the validity of quantum mechanics. And we will never know if there's really any convincing evidence for spooky action, or if there ever has been. This video is brought to you by extremefinitism.com.